If you're going to go out in the snow, you must be sure to have the right clothes on, said Thumbelina's mum.
Of course I will, replied Thumbelina, and ran to her wardrobe to see which garment would be suitable for snow and the freezing cold. Her mum Mater had bought some new clothes for her daughter. Dresses, trousers, jumpers, socks, summer sandals and winter boots, and a hat. Thumbelina couldn't decide what to wear. She had never seen snow before, so she didn't know which garment would be most suitable.
A hat is probably a good idea, so that I don't get snow in my hair, and a pair of trousers and a jumper. But I don't want to tramp around in those thick boots, so I'll take the sandals, said Thumbelina, looking at herself in the mirror once she'd got dressed. She went out in the snow. Not that much snow had fallen yet, but Thumbelina was so tiny that a single snowflake was the same size as she was. Her head wasn't cold, nor was the upper part of her body, nor her legs, and nor her feet either. But soon it started to really snow, with flakes as big as feathers floating down towards the ground. She trudged along. The snowdrifts went up to the tip of her nose, and she had to stand on tiptoe to see where she was going. And then she realized, suddenly, that part of her was freezing. Her toes. Now she understood why her mother had said that she shouldn't forget her boots. I'd better go home and put them on, she thought, turning around and setting off in the other direction. The snow had covered her tracks, and now the snowdrifts were so high that just the top of her hat could be seen. It got dark early in winter, and she had to hurry back before it became pitch black. The snowdrifts had reached well over her head, and she had to dig a tunnel to move forward. Her feet were frozen stiff, and a shell of frost had formed around her toes.